Now, yesterday, the High Court ruled that the states and territories could not introduce their own road user charges for electric vehicles. It says only the federal government has that power under the Constitution. Treasurer Jim Chalmers says he'll consider the implications of the ruling.
So we want to work with the Victorians and with the other states and territories on policy relating to electric vehicles. Now, clearly the decision taken by the High Court has implications for that, for the Comstate tax mix.
Joining me now is Michael Bradley. He's Managing Director of the Australian Automobile Association. Michael, thanks for your time. Where will the government head when it comes to road user charges? Because with more EVs, there's less fuel excise. Less fuel excise means less money going into roads. What do they do with road user charges?
Well, it's a good question. It's something we've been talking about for more than a decade because, well, the High Court ruling hasn't solved this. All it's done is identify whose problem this is to fix. Status quo is not an option here. If we want our road user charging, our motoring tax regime to be either sustainable or equitable, we've got big changes coming.
But so they don't want to charge EV drivers more because they want the uptake in electric vehicles.
Yeah, we can do both. We can walk and chew gum here. The government's own budget paper shows that over the next 4 years, fuel excise collections are going up, even though the proportion of Australian motorists who pay it is going down. Excise is indexed. In a high inflation environment, this is going up and up, and the people who are paying it are the people who are driving petrol and diesel cars. Now, the government is right to be incentivising the uptake of EVs. That's a good thing. It's what we support. But you can't incentivise EVs into the community or into the country without also fixing the systemic tax problems that come with this. We need a system in which people who use the road pay to use the road. And this is becoming an equity problem because if you look at where EVs are most prevalent, the electorates where EV uptake is highest, these are Australia's most wealthy electorates. Okay. So we currently have a situation where you've got an existing regime. Motoring tax is going up and up in Australia's poorest electorates, but it's being opted out of in the wealthiest electorates.
So they've got to come up with some sort of deal on that. On this other campaign you announced and you're running, well, I spoke to you about it a couple of weeks ago,
yep.
Data saves lives. This is to get the states to release data on the safety of their roads.
Yep.
You're getting a lot of support across the political divide, but not so much from the government yet. What's happening there?
Well, we're having a really interesting response. The political response looks very different to the community response. At a political level, we've had great buy-in from former transport ministers. Three of the four first people to sign up to our campaign were former transport ministers. They are very live to the road safety crisis that's occurring on our roads. All coalition MPs are now on board with our campaign, and Teals and Independents are also starting to come on board because they have an interest in integrity and transparency. Unfortunately, we haven't had a response from the government on this yet. However, when you look at the voters in electorates that are engaging with our campaign, contacting their MPs, they are overwhelmingly in government, Teal, and green seats.
Okay, well, we will stay in touch and hopefully the government does get back to you sooner rather than later via the Transport Minister, Catherine King. Thank you, Michael.